Hello and welcome to Dynamic Coding. My name is Yogesh Singh and in this tutorial we are going to create a simple notepad app using tkinter Python. So this is how our GUI or you can say notepad will look like. So this is a simple notepad with some basic menu or you can say method of creating new file, open a old file, save and save as file and exit the app. You can type anything on it. So now let's try to build it. So as you can see, I created a new Python file in which I first import the all required modules. So I'm just writing a comment, import modules, and the modules which I am using are from tkinter import all. You can also import all the required class instead of using this star symbol, directly pass the class or method name. Now the second thing is from tkinter import file dialog and message box. We have to import file dialog and message box separately. Now the second thing is from tkinter dot scroll text import scroll text. Now as you can see, our modules are imported. Now let's create our main window or also in tkinter we call it as root window. I am using class and object method for creating our main window. So create a class name PyNote. Inside the class, define init and with self I am passing root, then self dot root is equal to root. Now if name is equal to main, then root is equal to tk. Create a tk object, then root dot title. The title is PyNote from dynamic coding. Now root dot geometry. The geometry is 500 x 500. Now the next step is root not root PyNote. Inside PyNote I am passing the root of object, then root dot main loop. So now let's try to run it and check whether our GUI is created or not. So as you can see, our GUI window or root window is created. Now the next step is to add widget on our GUI. So adding widgets. So the first widget is create menu bar. So the first widget I am creating is or adding is menu bar. So create a menu bar. Menu bar is equal to menu, and inside menu I have to pass self dot root. Now the next step is creating a file menu. So file menu is equal to menu, and I want to place it on menu bar, and the tier of is equal to 0. Now the next step is to add command on the file menu. So file menu dot add command, and the first command label is new, and command is equal to none. I am passing none because at that time I did not create any method. So that's why I am passing none here. Now the second is file menu dot add command, and inside it label is equal to the label of the next command, or you can say sub menu is open, then command is equal to none. Now let's copy and paste it. Control C, Control V, Control P, V. Now the next command is save, and then save as, and the last one is exit. And now let's add a separator. So file menu dot add separator, it will add a separator line between the submenus, and in the exit submenu I am passing the commands, which is self dot root dot quit. It will close our GUI window whenever this exit submenu is clicked. Now let's configure our menu bar on the root window and file menu on the menu bar. So file menu dot add underscore cascade, inside it I have to pass label is equal to file, and menu is file menu. Now the next step is self dot root dot config, and here menu is equal to menu bar. Now let's try to run it and check our menu bar. So as you can see, our menu bar is added and our submenu are also added with a separator line. And let's try to click on this exit submenu. As you can see, when I click on the exit menu, the window is automatically destroyed by the method root.quit. Now the next step is to add a text box where we will write our content. So adding text box. So for text box, I am using the scroll text widget of tkinter. So self dot text area is equal to scroll text should be placed on root. Font style should be font family Arial, and font size is 14. Now undo is equal to true. It enable the undo and redo feature of the text box. Now wrap equal to word, and now place it. So self dot text area dot place rel height is equal to 1 and width is equal to 1. So basically I am using rel height and rel width command, a parameter, not instead of using x and y and height and width, because the rel width and rel height command change the size of, sorry, rel height and rel width parameters of place command change the size of scroll text widget according to the size of UI. Okay, so that's why I'm using rel height and rel width. Now let me try to run it. Okay, so it's giving me error WIDTH. Again. Okay, as you can see, when I try to increase the width of the GUI, the text box size is automatically increasing with it. And when I try to increase the height of text box is also increasing and decreasing according to the GUI. And now write something, hello world. So as you can see, our text box is added perfectly with the scroll bar also. Now the next step is to add method on the, now to define method for our GUI. So define methods. Now first method, I have to create some method, four method basically. So save method, and the second method is save as method, थर्ड मेथड इज ओपन फाइल मेथड एंड द फोर्थ मेथड इज न्यू फाइल मेथड. सो नाउ स्टार्ट विद द सेम मेथड. सो बिफोर सेव मेथड आई हैव टू क्रिएट द सेव एज मेथड और आई हैव टू क्रिएट अ वेरिएबल फर्स्ट. सो वेरिएबल इज सेल्फ डॉट फाइल नेम इज इक्वल टू नन. सो बेसिकली दिस वेरिएबल स्टोर द करेंट फाइल नेम एंड इट हेल्प इन सेव एंड ओपन ओपनिंग द फाइल. ओके नाउ लेट्स कोड इफ self dot file name. So if it will check this file is already saved or not. If this file is already saved, then the self dot file name variable store the current file name. But at that time, it is when the file is not saved, file name variable store a variable with store a very value none. Now inside try if use try, then pass accept. Exception as e. Now message box dot show error. Error and the title of the error is PyNote says and the error is e. Now else inside else I am using pass. Now let's code our try block. So inside it I am text area content. Inside the try block first I will fetch all the data written in the notepad text box. So using the self dot text area dot get from 1.0 to end. It means from row 1 column 0 to end of the scroll text or text box. Now the next step is with open self dot file name in write mode as f f dot write. Write the content of text box on the file which I opened. Okay, inside the else statement I have to write self dot save as. So basically this the working of the function is like that. If the file is already saved, then it will again rewrite the content when I click on save. But if the file is not saved, so first it will call the save as method by in which I save the file and then apply do some other operation on it. Now let's code our self.save as method. So inside it I am using try block and then pass accept exception as e message box dot show error. Inside error the title of the message box is Python or PyNote says and the error message is E. Now I forgot to add no. Okay. Now that write the try block. So self dot file name is equal to file dialog. Here I have to write equal to dot ask open file name and inside it I have to write some extra things like initial file or just copy paste the from my old code. I will explain all the thing which I am using here. So basically file dialog asks open file name method accepts some parameter which is initial file which is the initial file name then the default extension, then the file types, which means on which type of file we can access or save using our PyNode notepad. Okay, now after selecting the name of the file, if self dot file name, if the user selected a file name or try to save the file name, then instead of open I have to write ask save as file name. Okay, after that self dot file name, and inside it with open self dot file name in write mode as f dot write. Okay, I have to extract the text area content as well. So after this, text underscore area underscore content is equal to self dot text area dot get, and the same code 1.02, and in here write the text area content. So now my save and save as method created. Now the last thing is adding a message box dot show info with display a message of file is saved. So PyNode says, and the message is file is saved as, and using f string slash n. Here I am passing the self dot file name of the file. Now add this method on the menu bar and try to run it. So inside it I have to write self dot save method, and here self dot save as method. Now let's try to run it. Now let's write something like hello world. Now let's save it. So as you can see, a save as dialog box is open. Now I am saving it this file as hello.txt. Now save. As you can see, file is saved as, and the path of the file with the file name is coming on my message box when I click OK. Now close the GUI, and you can see hello.txt is created when I click here, and my texts are here, hello world. In this way you can create the other file or save them for these file. Now the last two methods are open file and save new file. Now let's create the open file. So self.file name is equal to file dialog dot ask open file name. It will ask for the name of file which you want to open, and then default extension of the file is dot txt. Now file types, so which type of file I want to open on my PyNode. So let's copy the same code, control C, paste here and remove this one. Okay, now I can open markdown file, Python script, JavaScript file, HTML file and CSS file on my GUI or notepad. Now the next step is, if file name, but if self dot file name If something is written in the file name variable, then self dot text area dot delete, it will delete the old content of the text widget or scroll text, then with open self dot file name in read mode as f. Now the next step is add the content of file on our text box. So self dot text area dot insert and insert from row 0 column 1, and what I want to insert is f dot read. So it will read all the content of the notepad file or any file and place it on our text box. Now the next step is to create new file method, but before let's call and try this open file method. So here self dot open file. Now try this. So when I click on this file, okay, when I click on this file and when I click this open menu, as you can see a open file dialog box is created. When I click this, let's suppose I want to open this Python file, then select this file and click on open. So as you can see, this file is created here, is open here when I click on full screen. Now okay, though as you can see our open method, save as and save method are working completely fine. Now the next step is to define our new file method. So defining this method is not a big task. So self dot file name is equal to none, and then self dot text area dot delete from 1.0 to end. So my new file method is created, is defined. Now let's try it. Now let's create another file with say like and subscribe. Coding. Now let's save it. I'm saying it's subscribe.txt, and you can see my file is saved. Now let's delete the content of the file and go to open file. Click on the subscribe text file and try to open it. As you can see, my file is open. Now when I click on new file, okay, the one thing which I forgot is to call this, or sorry, add this method on the menu bar. So here I have to write self dot new file, sorry for that. And now let's try to run it. Now let's open our file, select this file and open. Now let's create a new file, click on new. As you can see, our new file is created. So this is how you can create a simple notepad app using tkinter. We can also create a multifunctional notepad app, but the video tutorial of that will be uploaded after 500 subscribers. So if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. You can check out the source code link from the description, or you can visit my website also for the source code or more amazing projects like this. And please subscribe. That's all.